गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस लॉ ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस। सो यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड इन मीन टाइम सम नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम वाज देयर। ओके सो आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दैट एंड दैट वाज वी स्टार्टेड इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ टू जीन्स। ओके इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ टू जीन्स अंडर दैट लॉ ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट वी सीन। ओके so just for quick review, if anyone is having any problem, so you can recover that one. Okay, so yesterday what we seen that in inheritance of two genes. Okay, in this inheritance of two genes, one law came, that was law of independent assortment. And this law is known as Mendel's third law of inheritance. So Mendel's third law of inheritance. Now, as a term suggests, independent means when two characters containing factors are having what? They are mixed up, okay, crossing each other. Then an independent character also shown that was different from their parent. So what we can say, he took two type of characters. One took seed shape and one took seed color. Okay, so Mendel's chosen seed shape and seed color, and seed shape he took two allele. One was round, capital R, and one was wrinkled, small r. Okay, and in seed color also he took yellow and green. Yellow was dominant, capital Y, and green was recessive. Okay, so what happens here when a cross is made between, okay, when a cross is made between yellow round and wrinkled green seeds, so we can write here, when a cross made between yellow round and wrinkled green seeds. Okay, what was that? Yellow round and wrinkled green seeds. So what happens here? Here an independent, okay, in F1 generation no problem is there. Okay, In F1 generation, only yellow and round, that was dominant. Only yellow and round seeds were obtained. But In F2 generation, when selfing occurs, what happens? Four types of phenotypes observed. Okay, and what was that? That we have to see. So crosses made between RRYY into small r small y, it is what? Parental character. Now here gametes were there, R and Y capital, and this is a small r small y, this is what? Gametes. Okay, now here what happens? Crossing happens. So F1 generation what came? Small r capital R, small y and capital Y. So this is came in F1 generation, and this is what? All round and yellow seeds. Okay, this is what? Round and yellow seeds. Now, it is telling that in F2 generation, so now we have to see F2 generation. This F1 generation, again what it is done? It done self-crossing. So, R, R, Y, Y crosses with same capital R, small y then. Okay. Now, here how many type of gametes are there? Four types. One is a capital R, capital Y, small r, capital Y, capital R, small y. Similarly, small r, small y. Same things happens here also. Capital R, capital Y, small r, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, small y. Then we have to see the offsprings in F2 generation with the help of Punnett square. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here also 1, 2, 3 and 4. So total 16 is there. You can also see that 4 into 4 is equal to what? 16. So in Punnett square, how much boxes will be there? 16. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 is 2, 4 is 2, 16. Now here male, here female. Same is there, RY, so capital, small, small r, small y. Similarly here, okay. Now we have to see that, capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. Capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, sorry, small r, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, small y, small y, small r, small r, small y, small y. Okay, now here capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. Capital R, capital Y, small y. Capital R, capital R, small y, small y. Capital R, small y, small y. Capital R, capital Y, small y. Small r, capital Y, small y. Okay. Capital R, small y, small y. Here, small r, small y, small y. Okay. Now, here you can see that. How much is there? So, here, 16 offsprings are found. Okay. Now, one by one, we will see that how many phenotypes are there and genotypes are there. So, first case is this. This is what? Round and yellow. So, we have to see. Round and yellow. First one. So round, this is also round and yellow. This is round and yellow. This is also round and yellow. This is also round and yellow. This is not. This is not. This is not. This is round and yellow. This is round and yellow. This is not. This is not. This is round and yellow. Okay. So how much there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It should be one more. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Where that missing? So while going into that, it will come what? 9. Okay. And next is what? Round and green. So it will come what? 3. Then what? Wrinkled and yellow. Okay, it will come what? 3. And wrinkled and green. It is coming what? 1. So this is what? This is the phenotypic ratio. But here round and yellow, it is what? Parental character. Wrinkled and green, it is also what? Parental character. But these two, round and green and wrinkled and yellow, these two are independent character. So this is independent character. Okay, so this is independent character, and that's why it is known as what? Law of independent assortment. Now here if you are seeing, so here phenotypic ratio, questions are coming, dihybrid, because two genes are there, inheritance of two gene, so phenotypic ratio in dihybrid cross is equal to what? 9:3:3:1. Same genotypic ratio. So genotypic ratio in dihybrid cross is, we seen yesterday, 1:2:2:2, 1:2:2:2, 2:4:2, 1:2:2:1. Okay, so this is what? This is genotypic ratio of dihybrid. This is phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross. Okay, now next we have to see dihybrid test cross ratio. So come on, that dihybrid test cross ratio. Okay, here we know that F1 generation into recessive, what is that? F1 hybrid into recessive parent. This is known as what? Test cross. So recessive parent, this is known as test cross. Okay, so F1 hybrid, what we see here, R small r, capital Y small y, and recessive parent means all are having recessive condition. So here we have seen that all the four gametes, R Y small r, capital Y small, capital R small y, small r small y, and here how many gametes are there? Only one gametes are there. Okay, now one by one they are fusing to each other. So capital R small r, capital Y small y, one type is there. Second, small r, capital Y small y. Third, capital R, small y, small y. And fourth, small r, small y, small y. Okay, so these four types, 1:1:1:1. So dihybrid test cross ratio is equal to 1:1:1:1. Okay, now we already seen dihybrid phenotypic ratio 9:3:3:1, dihybrid genotypic ratio 1:2:2:1:2:2:4:1:2:2:1, that we seen. Test cross ratio, dihybrid test cross ratio 1:1:1:1, that we already seen here. Now questions are coming in the medical exams, direct questions are coming, what is the phenotypic ratio, what is genotypic ratio, sometime also question asked in inheritance of three genes, trihybrid, that we seen here, trihybrid. So trihybrid, how we can see, we can calculate, that we have to see here. This is very very important, and you have to calculate that one from the formula. So if questions are coming trihybrid phenotypic ratio, phenotypic ratio. Okay, so trihybrid means n is equal to what? 3. Okay, so dihybrid, what we seen phenotypic ratio, so we know that phenotypic ratio is equal to 3:1 to the power n, and here what is that? 3:1 to the power 3, or we can write 3:1 into 3:1 into 3:1, and we know that this dihybrid, so dihybrid ratio is 9:3:3:1, and we have to multiply with this 3:1. Okay, so now come on that, what will that? First we will take this, so 9:3:27:9:19, then 3:3:9, is to 3. Again, 3 is to 3, 9 is to 3. Then 1, so 3 is to 1, 3, and 1 is to 1. So what is that? Trihybrid phenotypic ratio is 27. We can simplify this. 27 is to 9 is to 9 is to 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. Okay. So you can remember easily 27 if you will adding this one 9, 9, 9, so 27. This 3, 3, 3, so 9 is to 1. So you can remember easily 27 is to 9 is to 9 is to 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. It is the phenotypic trihybrid ratio. Okay, this is very important. Many times I have seen questions in the medical exam. Okay, so this is phenotypic ratio. Now come on, genotypic ratio, how it is coming? So trihybrid genotypic ratio, trihybrid genotypic ratio, and here also trihybrid means n is equal to 3. We already know that trihybrid genotypic ratio. So genotypic ratio formula is what? Genotypic ratio formula is 1 is to 2 is to 1 to the power n. So here we can write 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. So these three we can write here. So how we can calculate this? We know that this is already we have seen in dihybrid cross. So this is 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 4 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. Okay. Now we have to multiply with this one. 1 is to 2 is to 1. So we have to see that first we will multiply with this. So 1 is to 2 is to 1. Then this one 2 is to 4 is to 2. Then 1 is to 2 is to 1. Then 2 is to 4 is to 2. Then 4 is to 8 is to 4. Then 2 is to 4 is to 2. Then 1 is to 2 is to 1. Then 2 is to 4 is to 2. Then last 1 is to 2 is to 1. So it is what? 12, 12, 42. 12, 12, 42. 48. Then reverse. 42, 42, 12, 12, 42, 12, 1. Okay. So this is what? Trihybrid genotypic ratio. Okay. And we already seen trihybrid phenotypic ratio. Now come on. We have to see trihybrid traced cross ratio. This trihybrid is very important. Traced cross ratio. So trihybrid traced cross ratio, we already know that formula is what? Traced cross ratio formula is 1 is to 1 to the power n. Here n is what? 3. So what we can write? 1 is to 1 to the power 3. So 1 is to 1 multiplied by 1 is to 1 multiplied by 1 is to 1. And this we know already. 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. This came in which, where it came? Dihybrid. Now we have to see for this one. So first 1 is to 1. Second 1 is to 1. Third 1 is to 1. And fourth 1 is to 1. Okay. So this is what? This is your trihybrid traced cross ratio. So you have to remember this one. Okay. Very, very important one is trihybrid phenotypic ratio. 27 is to 9 is to 9 is to 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. Similarly, genotypic ratio. This one is the genotypic ratio. 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 4 is to 2. Is to 1 is to 2, 1 is to 2, 4 is to 2, 4 is to 8, 4 is to 2, 4 is to 2, 1 is to 2, 1 is to 2, 4 is to 2, 1 is to 2, 1, 1. Okay. So this is the what? Genotypic ratio. Traced cross ratio is what? 1 is to 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 1. Okay. So this is test cross ratio. This we have to remember. Okay. Now, next we have to see. Next is pleiotropic genes. So pleiotropy means multiple phenotypic effect. Single gene having multiple phenotypic effect. So now we have to see that. Okay, now we have to see that pleiotropic genes. And pleiotropic genes means the gene which contain multiple phenotypic effects. So what we can say, single gene with multiple phenotypic effect. It is single gene. With multiple phenotypic effect. Multiple phenotypic effect. So that is known as pleiotropic genes. Okay. Now, it happens what? It is showing their phenotypic effect either one time, either simultaneously, either one by one. Okay, so the process that is showing this one is known as what? Pleiotropy. So what we can say, a number of characters simultaneously influencing by the process. So a number of characters simultaneously influences by the process known as, that is known as what? Pleiotropy. Okay, so process name is pleiotropy and a gene showing effect, that is known as pleiotropic genes. Okay, now if number of related effects, okay, if what happens, number of related effect caused by a gene, that is known as a syndrome. What is that? Syndrome. So what we can say, sometimes a number of multiple effects caused by a gene. Okay, sometimes what happens? A number of multiple effects are caused by genes. These together called what? These together called syndrome. So these together called syndrome. Okay. Now, if we are seeing that, for example, if we are taking that example, in cotton, a gene for lint, okay, in cotton, a gene for lint also influences many phenotypic effects. What are that? That we have to see. So, for example, in cotton, a gene for lint, okay. In cotton, a gene for lint also influences. What are the characters they influencing? So also influences height. So first characters, what he is showing? First is height. Then what? Size of bowl. Okay. So next is size of bollworm is there. So size of bowl, height. Okay, another is what? number of ovules production. See, only one gene that is dying. So number of ovules production. Okay, number of ovules production. And what are the other things they are controlling? Viability of seeds. This already we discussed in first chapter. Viability of seeds, etc. Okay. So this sowing the effect is known as what? Pleiotropic genes. Okay. If we are seeing in Drosophila. So Drosophila also controlling many things, a single gene. What are that? Those things are size of wings, longevity, okay, position of fertility, like that. So another example is in Drosophila. Drosophila means fruit fly. Drosophila melanogaster is the complete zoological name for fruit fly. So for example, in Drosophila melanogaster. Melanogaster. So this is what? Fruit fly. Fruit fly. So in Drosophila melanogaster or fruit fly, a single gene controls. What are the things they are controlling? Controls. First, wing size. Okay. What are the size of wing that is controlled by that? Then balancing is there. So character of balancers also controlling. Character of balancers. That balancing is there. So character of balancers. Another thing is what? Position of fertility. Okay. Position of fertility, longevity, etc. So like that, all it is controlling. So position of fertility, longevity, etc. Okay. So this only one single gene controlling these different phenotype or different phenotypic character. So that is known as what? Pleiotropic genes, and process is known as what? Pleiotropy. Now, most common example in the case of P. Okay, so P here, what control? One gene control start synthesis and also control shape of the seed. So another example is in case of P. For example, in case of P. P means, what is the botanical name? Pisum sativum. So in case of P, one single gene controls start synthesis. One single gene controls starch synthesis, as well as what? Shape of the seed. As well as shape of the seed. And this example is a very important. Okay. So what single gene controlling? So controlling star synthesis as well shape of the seed in case of P. Okay. Now, come on, one questions are there. Question is that, how many phenotypes? Question is that, how many phenotypes or genotypes? Okay, here questions are there. Come on that. How many genotypes and phenotypes, okay, how many genotypes and phenotypes are produced in F2 generation? Are produced in F2 generation. Okay, are produced in एफ टू जनरेशन इन ए डाई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस, ओके, इन ए डाई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस, इन ए डाई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस इफ बोथ आर शोइंग, व्हाट दे आर शोइंग, इफ बोथ जीन्स आर शोइंग प्लियोट्रॉपिक इफेक्ट, सो इफ बोथ आर प्लियोट्रॉपिक, प्लियोट्रॉपिक, ओके. नाउ हियर ऑप्शंस आर देयर, फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज देयर, डाइहाइब्रिड मीन्स एन इज इक्वल टू टू, ओके, फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज देयर 9, अननोन, सेकेंड ऑप्शन इज देयर 8, नोन, थर्ड ऑप्शन इज देयर 7, अननोन, एंड फोर्थ ऑप्शन इज देयर नन ऑफ दीज, ओके. नाउ इफ वी आर गोइंग इन टू देयर सोल्यूशन, सो वी नो दैट प्लियोट्रॉपी मीन्स वॉट, ओनली फिनोटिपिक इफेक्ट इज हैविंग डिफरेंसेस, बट जीनोटिपिक इज सेम, सो वी ऑलरेडी नो जीनोटाइप्स नंबर इज इक्वल टू 3 to the power n, एंड n हियर वॉट 2, सो 3 to the power 2 इट इज 9, ओके, सो 9 इज देयर, एंड फिनोटाइप्स वी डोंट नो एवरीथिंग, ओके, सो इट इज अननोन, सो व्हाट इज दैट आंसर, इट शुड बी ए, सो 9 टाइप ऑफ जीनोटाइप्स एंड अननोन टाइप्स ऑफ फिनोटाइप्स, फिनोटाइप्स मे कंट्रोलिंग मोर देन वन फिनोटाइपिक कैरेक्टर्स, ओके, सो इट इज अननोन, सो वी हैव टू सी. नाउ नेक्स्ट जीन दैट इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट एंड नोन एज अ लीथल जीन, लीथल मीन्स डेथ, डेथ कॉजिंग जीन, now next one is lethal gene. We already known that all the genes present are not always useful, some of them are harmful, okay, so those genes which are harmful or having or causing a death, that is known as what, lethal genes, okay, so what we can say, all the genes present in an organism are not useful, so all the genes present in organism are not useful, okay, some of them are harmful, and even causes death, and even causes what, death, or in biological term it is a lethality, so we can say death or lethality, and from this lethal or lethal genes are coming, okay. Now first time one scientist was there, that name was L. Kionot. He reported this lethal gene. So which scientist was there? It was reported first time by L. Kionot. Okay. It was reported by which scientist? L. Kionot, and he told that yellow mice never exist. What told? And he proved that yellow mice means rat never exist due to lethality. Due to lethality means the gene which contain that one having what? Death. Okay. So what happens? Which one is having? So yellow dominant mice never ever present. Okay. Yellow dominant. So what is that? So yellow mice in yellow dominant. Yellow dominant mice. Now come on that. So which one is existing? Capital Y, small y. Capital Y, small y. This is yellow heterozygous. Heterozygous. Now, how much gametes are there? We have to see that. Two gametes are there. This is gametes. This is parental character. Now, when this one is fused, this offspring happens one, getting death. Then y small y exist, and small y this also exist. Okay, so what is that? This small y, it is having brown color mice. This yellow and yellow, it is what? It is yellow but having heterozygous yellow. Heterozygous, we can say that heterozygous yellow. Now, if questions are coming, what is the ratio of lethal gene? So this is having a death, no? So it will come what? This is 2 and this is 1. So here what will come? Ratio is 2:1. Okay, and this ratio you have to remember. So lethal gene ratio is 2:1. This is the question that asking. Okay, now one more example. Just we seen here yellow color mice. Okay, yellow color mice. So we seen here. So what is that? One was yellow and one was brown. Okay, so here yellow dominant YY does not exist. They causing what? Death. Same thing happens in snapdragon anti-ranum magus. So we have seen that one example. Lethal gene. LQ0, you have to remember that. Who first discovered this one? Reported this one. So LQ0. In which yellow mice he observed. Okay. Now, next example. In anti-rhinum magus. Anti-rhinum magus. Okay. And this is having common name snapdragon. Okay. This is snapdragon flower. Snapdragon flower. Now, here, what is that? Yellow leaf. Okay. Here, yellow leaf variety existing, but that is having what? Heterozygous condition, or that is also known as a Oria variety. So Oria variety, this is Latin word, or this means yellow leaf. Okay, also same Oria variety, and existence is what? Capital G, small g. Here also capital G, small g. This is parental. Now gametes are there, capital G, small g. Here also capital G, small g. This is gametes. Now this capital G and capital G, as we seen here, YY. So this is causing a death. So no existence. Capital G, small g, this is yellow leaf, but yellow what? Heterozygous. Heterozygous. This one, same, capital G, small g, yellow heterozygous. Okay, so this what came here. Okay, so these what came here, this one capital is death, this is having green one. Now, so here also what we have seen, ratio is what here? These 2 is to 1. Okay. So always a lethal gene ratio is 2 is to 1. That you have to remember. Okay. So lethal gene. Now, one question I have seen in medical exam. What was that question that we have to discuss here? Question was, what would be the phenotypic ratio? Question is, what would be the phenotypic ratio? What would be the phenotypic ratio in F2 generation? In F2 generation in a dihybrid cross. So in F2 generation in dihybrid cross. Okay. In F2 generation in dihybrid cross, if both the genes show lethality. Okay. If both the genes show lethality, means lethal genes. Both genes are what? Lethality in homozygous dominant state. Okay, now options are there. First option is there, 2 is to 2 is to 2 is to 2. So first is 2 is to 2 is to 2 is to 2. Next option is there, 4 is to 2 is to 2 is to 1. 4 is to 2 is to 2 is to 1. Next option is there, 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. And next option is there, none of these. Okay. Now, if you understand lethal gene, then you will solve this problem. Now, here what it is telling? It is telling that crosses. Okay. It is telling what? Crosses happens. Dihybrid crosses there. Now, so lethal gene ratio we know. Lethal gene ratio, it is 2 is to 1, and it is telling that both the genes show lethality. So what would be the phenotypic ratio? So phenotypic ratio in dihybrid lethal genes will be equal to what? 2 is to 1 multiplied by 2 is to 1, because both is showing. Now come on their multiplication. So 2 to the 4 is to 2. Then this one, 2 is to 1. So what will the answer? 4 is to 2 is to 2 is to 1. So this is the solution. Okay. Now, so this what we seen? This we seen lethal gene. What we seen? Pleiotropy we seen. Okay. Now, come on, some questions are there, important questions that we have to see here. This question. Now, one question is there, expression of only one. Expression of only one type. Okay, expression of only one type of parental character. So we have to write that. Expression of only one parental character. Expression of only one parental character. In monohybrid cross. Monohybrid means n is equal to 1. In monohybrid hybrid cross. Okay, so here n is equal to what? 1. In mono hybrid cross, in F1 generation, okay, in F1 generation, okay, in F1 generation, followed by expression of both the characters. Okay, expression of both the characters in F2 generation. Both the characters means parental, we are telling both the parental characters in F2 generation. Okay, and this is explained by, so first generation showing only parental, next generation both the parental character, jo hidden is also there, recessive and dominant. So this is explained by, okay, so this is explained by, what is that? First option is there, law of segregation. First is law of segregation. Second is law of dominance. Third is both A and B. And next is none. Okay, so it is showing what? Expression of only one parental character in F1 generation, that is showing law of dominance. And expression of both the parental characters in F2 generation, it is showing what? Law of segregation. So what will be the answer here? Both A and B. Okay, now another question is there, Mendel's work remain unrecognized till 1900. What is that reason? Mendel's work remain unrecognized 1900, 1884 he died, and 1900 Sirmak, Karl Kranz, okay, Hugo de Vries, these three scientists rediscovered their experiment. So it is, question is there, Mendel's work remain unrecognized till 1900 due to the following reason. So what was the reason? Due to the following reasons. Okay, now first reason is that, what is that first reason? His work could not be widely published. Okay, his work could not be widely published due to less publisher. Okay, now next options were there, his approach using mathematical statics. Okay, what is that? His approach used mathematics. Okay, his approach used mathematics and unacceptable, that was unacceptable to biologists of that time, and unacceptable to biologists of that time. Okay, another one was, what he does, he was mathematician and discovered biology related work. Okay, and last is all of these. So what will the answer? Right, so it is all of these. So this is remain unrecognized till 1900 due to the following reason. What was the reason? Work could not widely published. Second, he approached used mathematics and unacceptable to biologists of that time, and he was mathematician and discovered biology related work. That's why what happened, his work was remain unrecognized. Now, next question is there. Pea plants were more suitable than cattle. Pea plants chosen by Mendel, garden pea. So pea plants were more suitable than cattle. Okay, pea plants were more suitable than cattle for Mendel experiment because. Okay, so what was the reason? So first is, there were no breeding records of cattle. There were no records for breeding of cattle. First reason is this. Next reason is, pea plants can be self-fertilized ideally. Okay. Third option is that cattle are not easy to maintain. And fourth one is none of these. Okay, and fourth one is what? None of these. Now, what is that correct answer? Yes, right. So pea plants can be self-fertilized ideally. Okay, now next question is there. Two allelic genes are located on. Now, option one is there. Same chromosome. Option two is two homologous chromosome. Option three is two non-homologous chromosome. And fourth one is none of these. So we already know two allelic genes are located on where? Two homologous chromosome. Where it is? Two homologous chromosome. Okay. Now another question is there. In a इन ए क्रॉस 45 टॉल, 45 टॉल एंड 15 ड्वार्फ. ओके, 45 टॉल एंड 15 ड्वार्फ प्लांट्स वेयर ऑब्टेन, ड्वार्फ प्लांट्स वेयर ऑब्टेन्ड. ओके, सो द जीनोटाइप ऑफ पेरेंट्स वॉज, व्हाट इज दैट, द जीनोटाइप्स ऑफ पेरेंट वॉज. The genotypes of parents was. Okay, now first genotype is capital T crosses with capital T, next is t crosses with t. Next is capital T crosses with small t, and last is capital T small. Hello, tell me, sir. Ah, yeah. Oh, voice is not clear. Oh, it is not showing. Video not showing. Wait, wait, sir. I am connecting again, sir. Okay, sir. Hello. So, may I start from here, sir? Okay. What was that, sir? So, from here, I have to start, sir? Okay. Thank you. So what was we discussing, that the genotype of parents was, okay, here the question was asked that in a cross 45, what is telling, 45 tall and 15 dwarf. So 45 tall, 15 dwarf, so we can say in easy way it is 3:1, and 3:1 is what, phenotypic ratio. So phenotypic ratio in what, monohybrid cross. Okay, so phenotypic monohybrid cross, where we can see that one, so this is the T and t, when we are selfing monohybrid cross ratio after F1 generation, so this is the ratio of what, F2 generation. Okay, so this is the solution. Okay, now next question is there, if, okay, come on that question only. So what is, next question is, what is the ratio of one pair? Here you have to give attention, one pair. What is the ratio of one pair? Okay, what is the ratio of one pair of contrasting character? One pair of contrasting character. Okay, one pair of contrasting character in F2, in F2 of dihybrid cross. So when it is coming one pair, okay, one pair, so immediately you have to keep in mind what will be the ratio. That will be 3:1. Here options more is there, 2:1, C is there, 1:1, and D is there, none of these. What will that? 3:1. Okay, because it is asking one pair of contrasting characters, so it will be 3:1. Till yet, what we discussed? We discussed allelic genetic interactions. Now, we have to discuss next is non-allelic genetic interactions. So come on that. Non-allelic genetic interactions. Non-allelic genetic interactions. Okay, non-allelic genetic interactions. Okay, so here how this impact are happens due to the genes. Okay, or it is also known as intergenic inheritance. So what we have to see here, also known as intergenic inheritance. Many ratios are there inside that. You have to remember that ratio. What is that? Okay, so this is very important, that a ratio. Directly questions are coming, the ratio. Now first here we will see complementary genes. First we have to see that complementary genes. Now as a term suggests, complementary means two are showing the effect, two different if are doing, so they are showing different effect, and when they come together, so they show a triple or third type of character. So what we can say, these are two pairs